here in the Midwest, we always seem to have plenty of fresh water. So, what's the big deal about saving water? Do you ever think about the resources, besides the water itself, you use each time you turn on your faucet? Unfortunately, we can't just drink the water as nature provides it. It has to be cleaned first. And that process starts here, at a water treatment plant, where high-powered pumps bring the water from its source and move it through a very complicated plant. These pumps and processes use a lot of electricity. In fact, 4% of all the electricity generated in the entire country is used just to bring us water. On top of that, even more energy is used to manufacture and transport all the chemicals needed for water treatment. Chemicals that take little particles out of the water, kill algae and bacteria, keep bubbles from forming, help prevent tooth decay, and even keep the water from destroying our pipes and water towers. Speaking of chemicals, a typical first step to purifying water is to add chemicals that make tiny particles in the water stick together to create bigger, heavier particles that settle to the bottom. What happens to these particles depends on what is in them. Sometimes they are sucked out and transported to a landfill, and sometimes they are spread out on fields to go back to nature. Pumps then send the water through a series of filters that take out teeny tiny bad things like parasites, bacteria, and viruses. From there, the water is carefully mixed with a chemical like chlorine that kills all the remaining bad stuff. Finally, the ready-to-drink water is pumped through distribution pipes and up into a big water tower where it's stored until we need it. But that's only half the story. What happens to the water after it goes down your drain? Well, it has to be cleaned, again, before it goes back to nature. That process starts here, in a wastewater treatment plant where more pumps use more electricity to move the wastewater into a holding pond. Heavy solids settle to the bottom and lighter particles like oil and grease float to the surface. The heavy and light stuff is removed. Some of it is held in an energy-consuming warming tank called a digester, where good bacteria eat all the harmful stuff. Then the sludge is often either used as fertilizer or sent to a landfill. Pumps move the water onto the secondary treatment, where more tiny helpful creatures called microorganisms are added to eat up the tiny bad stuff still in the water. The microorganisms are removed and the water goes off to the third stage, which cleans up anything that was left over by the first two. Finally, it's clean enough to go back into nature. So you see, by fixing leaks, adding low-flow shower heads, or just by turning off the tap, you're doing way more than just saving water. You're also saving electricity, fuel, reducing harmful greenhouse gases, saving landfill space, and conserving a whole lot of natural resources needed to clean our water, both coming from nature and going back to it. So, think about all that next time you're letting the water run. If everyone saves just a little water a day, it all adds up to a whole lot of good.